As you can see, we've had another week away, but I'm still going to give you a good episode of Science with Steph this week. And be sure to stay tuned to the end because I think I've worked out something pretty spectacular. Have you ever been watching a movie when...
somewhere, and then I'll brush and brush and brush and brush my hair. Jeez.
Just how much hair does Rapunzel have? How heavy is it? Would all that weight pull her hair out of her head? And anyway, what even is hair and why does it go really long on my head and really short on my arms? Welcome to Science with Steph, the show where I think way too much about the world around us and then share the best bits with you guys. This week I'm looking at human hair. What is it? Why does it grow? And in the movie Tangled, how heavy is all that hair? Well, first let's look at the human body. We grow hair almost all over our entire bodies. And the type of hair and where it is on your body can determine how long it is and how fast it grows. Every hair at any one time can be going through one of three phases of growth. That's the anagen phase, the catagen phase, and the telogen phase. The first phase is the anagen phase, where there's rapid cell division at the base of the follicle, producing lots of keratinocytes. This bulb grows and grows and gets squeezed out the follicle, where the cells die and produce keratin, which is a strong protein. And this strong strand of keratin pokes out of your skin and continues to grow throughout the whole anagen phase. This growth phase can last various different lengths of time depending where it is on your face or body. The anagen phase for your hair on your head typically lasts 3 to 6 years, allowing for a maximum growth length of around 1 or 2 meters. Though in Rapunzel's case, she clearly has some super producing anagen that just never stops. For normal, non-magical princesses, usually about 70 to 80% of any of your hair at any one time can be going through the anagen phase. The second phase is the catagen phase, where the blood stops flowing to the follicle and cuts off the bulb from the rest of the hair. That follicle shrinks and eventually pushes that existing hair up to the surface of the skin. And the third phase, which is the telogen or resting phase, typically lasts 1 to 4 months. The follicle at this point is dormant, and at the end of the phase, the follicle expands and the hair is released, called shedding. And after the follicle widens again, we're back to the anagen phase. So now that we know all this, I'm going to ask the important questions. How long is Rapunzel's hair and how heavy is it? So, from all the information I've gathered, Rapunzel's hair seems to change length quite a lot in the film. The longest it appears to be is about 21 or 22 metres. Using a hair mass of about 300 grams per metre gives a total weight of about 7 kilograms. That's about the weight of having 2 laptops hanging from your head. The world record for weight ever lifted by hair is 81.5 kilograms. That's 179 pounds for you Imperials out there. This was done by a Russian man named Abdulazizov. I can't pronounce that. That's heavier than me, and I'm pretty heavy. So Rapunzel's hair, while it's heavy, is well within the region of carryable, and I think I've worked out where her powers lie. Clearly her cells are just rapidly dividing, meaning that her hair grows much faster than the average person. It means that her magic keeps people looking young because their cells are rapidly dividing, and it can heal people using that power too. There you go, science is magic. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Science with Steph. I bring out new videos every Friday, so if you want to see my last video, you can click here. Or if you consider subscribing, click here. Till next time, bye!